Before we get the boxers into the ring, I just want to introduce our officials for this evening, our World Boxing Association officials who've come down for the fight. We have Mr. Guy Gutus, who is the supervisor for the WBA. The referee for tonight is Steve Smudger. The judge, one judge for the evening is Ms. Lynn Carter on the western side from the U.S. We also have Judge Steve Weisfeld from the U.S. in the northern side. And from Bermuda on the eastern side, a long association with teaches rugby, and also Bermuda Amateur Boxing Association, Mr. Vic Richmond. Okay, we're about to get the fighters into the ring. This is a World Boxing Association women's middleweight title fight. We're going to have the challenger enter the ring first. Making her way to the ring now, fighting out of the USA, Arkansas, Miss April Ward, weighing in at 156.25 pounds, a record of 8-4-1. She comes, she needs business. And as we wait for the champion, the timekeepers for tonight's bout, Mr. Kenny Simmons. And counting the knockouts, Mr. Craig Morfitt, both from Bermuda. We've got April in the ring. We're now waiting for our champion, our homegrown champion, who started her career fight night many years ago at number one chair.
Right.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, looks like we've got her ready. Entering the ring, fighting for Bermuda and Bermuda Sanchow, weighing in at 158.5 pounds, a record of 8-4-1, Teresa Perazzi. This will be 10 rounds of professional boxing. I would also like to ask whoever has the blow horn, please do not sound the blow horn during the match. It will confuse the boxers. Please, no blow horn.
And what we have been waiting for is now arrived. The WBA middleweight world title fight with defending champion Bermuda Teresa Perazzi taking on challenger American April Ward. We welcome Greg Fraser back into the broadcast booth.
Hello again, Mike. Hello again, Mike.
Welcome back, Greg.
Here we are, main event of the evening.
This is it. This is it. Round one, the first of 10 rounds. Gumbe is bringing, oh, a good left. Oh, Perazzi is coming out.
No time.
Yeah. No nonsense mood here. Quick left to the head of Ward. Oh, she has a wicked left, and she's headhunting. Perazzi going after the head of Ward. Ward trying to dance, using the jab. Oh, 3-4 blows.
Wow, yeah. If this continues, it doesn't really look as if it's going to last very long.
Yeah.
As you see, Mike, April is looking to pick her punches and land a couple of jabs, but Teresa is wasting no time in getting her inside and throwing some bigger punches, far bigger punches.
She knows that this could be the stepping stone for big things, Greg. To win here tonight, she could move into the big money.
Absolutely, yeah. She's looking to consolidate the belts. And I think perhaps Teresa also knows that the April is a little bit slighter than she is, so maybe April is looking to use her smaller frame, quicker hands, and Teresa is looking to get inside and land some bigger blows, slow her down straight from the get-go.
Should mention here, Greg, that Teresa is probably at her lowest weight for quite some time, 158, whereas April Ward tipped the scales at 156 during yesterday morning's weigh-in at the Fairmont Hamilton Princess Hotel. Oh, Ward is, she's, uh, she's a very respectable fighter.
Yeah,
she's a classy fighter.
She's carried it for herself. Teresa came out. She came out strong. Threw some big punches. April managed to ride it out. But I think you have to give the first round to Teresa there.
I think so. Just want to make quick mention here, Greg, our broadcast sponsors, Lindo's, Baptist, Magnum Power Force Gym, and the Captain's Lounge. You are watching Teachers Rugby Fight Night 14 at the Barclay Gymnasium. And all the action, of course, right here on Bermuda Sports Network. Round two of this WBA middleweight championship fight.
Let's see if things have slowed down a little bit into the second round.
Ward wisely ties her up. I believe Ward also has a slight reach advantage. So she's effectively trying to use the jab. Whereas Teresa is attempting to get inside.
Yeah, I think you're right, Mike. I think April is now trying to use her kind of ring smarts, a little bit superior speed to Teresa. Until we get to right there when Teresa lands a couple of bigger blows, and that slows April right down and backs her into a corner. Oh, that's a solid punch from Teresa.
She's throwing punches with bad intentions.
She absolutely is, but you know what? She needs to throw her big punches, but she also needs to be wary of April tying her up as well. What she really wants to do is throw those big punches, but still, and then get on the inside, but they still have the space to throw further punches and counter, and build on the punches that she throws. If she throws those big punches, but it allows April to tie her up, then she's no chance to go further with that. She throws the punches, hits April hard, and can keep throwing more punches, then there's opportunity for a knockout or a stoppage. But
yeah.
But if she allows April to tie her up, then she allows April a chance to recover.
Yeah, I would like to see Teresa use more of her right. She tees her up, and she's got the left cocked and ready.
Yeah.
But she
yeah.
doesn't
that's
use
a big
much
weapon.
Of the right.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
that's her power. That's her punch. I would like to see her use more of the right hand.
Yeah, she does seem to forget the jab so much and then just drop in and try and throw a big heavy left. But you're right, Mike. If she sets it up more with the...
And who did you give that round to?
I think, again, that's another round for Teresa, I believe.
Yeah.
I think for that one, again, April kind of started out well. She came out and she tried to be a bit more elusive. But ultimately, kind of maybe halfway through a round, Teresa caught her, slowed her down, and she backed her up two or three times and did much more busier work, backing her down to the ropes and throwing heavier punches. So as I say, I would give that round to Teresa again.
We're getting ready for round number three of this WBA middleweight world title fight.
And again, April's kind of starting out the same way, trying to be a bit more elusive. Trying to use that little bit of reach advantage, as you said, Mike, and just trying to stay away from Teresa.
Yes, I'm definitely noticing the... Oh, there's a bit of a right jab from Teresa, but We also should mention, Greg, that Ward opted not to use the chest protection. And she had to sign a waiver to do so.
It's totally innocent, Mike. I didn't realize that at all.
Yeah, that came out in the at the weigh-in.
The weigh-in?
Yeah. In round three of a 10-round fight, fight night 14. I'd like to say congratulations to all of the Teachers Rugby Football Club members who worked really hard to pull it all together. I think Alvin Harvey, the MC, said that this is actually the 22nd one, but the 14th one since you started.
What you did back to BAA and things, yeah.
Yeah. Well, that brings round three to a close. Very, very quickly here, Greg. Round three.
Oh. I think, to be honest, round three was a tough one to score. I think.
I think there wasn't much
clean work done from either of them.
So that you consider them on a tie.
Seconds out.
I would say it's a. Yeah. Yeah. I would legitimately say it's a tie, but at the end of the day, you have to give it to somebody.
Right.
I would like to give it to Reza, but for argument's sake, I would give it to April, just for the sake of getting her on the scoreboard.
We're in round four. Greg Fraser has given round three to the challenger, American April Ward. As you can see, Teresa Perazzi in the black top, the champion, is pursuing. Oh, good exchange there.
Absolutely, yes. April landed a couple of shots inside, and then Teresa fired right back with a couple of her own.
She's relying too much on that left.
Yeah, I have to say, I just hope Teresa is kind of, you know, taking proper account of herself and making sure she's enough wind to go to the left to the later rounds, because she's definitely more aggressive and definitely carrying the fight to April so far. But as I say, I hope she's enough in the tank to go to later rounds.
So she works on the body, now goes upstairs. This is where Teresa wants her, up against the ropes.
Absolutely.
Sort of neutralize Ward's jab when she has her pinned against the ropes or the corner. You know what I'm going to ask you, Greg?
I don't think there's any way you can give that round to April at all. That round for me was a round for Teresa.
All right. We'll be right back. I know some of the pre-fight build-up, Teresa made it clear that she doesn't want it to go the distance. I don't know. I don't know if it's going to go the distance, but I know that April Ward has taken her best shot in the first four rounds.
Yeah, absolutely, Mike. I think it's one of those things that they say in boxing that you don't want a fight to go the distance because you don't know what the judge is going to say. But at the same time, I don't know there's a way that a judge can score it any other than at least
one
of the Teresa.
Head, they are going at it right now, Greg. Neither of them wanted to back down from that slugfest.
But I think again, I mean, you have to give Teresa the benefit of the doubt on that one because she kept coming forward, she kept forcing April onto the back foot, and really, if it's in doubt between boxers, you give the advantage to the one coming forward.
Here
and
they
again,
go again,
and again, and again. Yeah, absolutely, Mike. Absolutely, Mike. April's doing well. She's getting a good account of herself, but still, Teresa is the one who's applying the pressure, and she's the one that's coming forward. So it's almost worth a half point around that the fighter coming forward gets the advantage.
Ward smartly ties her up. They both have identical 8-4 records. Just that April has one draw as well. We're approaching midway of this 10-rounder. We're in the fifth round. A good friend, Greg Fraser, co-commentator, has Teresa winning 3 of the 4 and April 1. And the champion is still pursuing. End of the round. Oh, don't drop your head on me now, Greg. Don't drop your head on me now.
Yeah, you know, again, that was another tough one to call, so I really don't know. I feel as though I get the last 4 rounds to April, so it's a good one to Teresa, but at the same time, I feel as though I should be 50-50 on the close rounds.
Stop beating around the bush, Greg.
Yeah.
Who did you give the round to?
I'm getting splinters somewhere, Mike. It's not very comfortable, I tell you. I'll give that one to Teresa. Let's say I'm calling it 50-50 for the close round, so it's one close round each. I'll give that one to Teresa. I still feel Teresa is in control of the fight. She's still forcing April onto the back foot. She's still being far busier.
Round 6 of a scheduled 10-rounder. The WBA middleweight world title fight.
But I do also think in that last fifth round, April showed a little bit more of what she might have. She came out a bit more positive in trying to throw some combinations towards Teresa. Let's see if she can carry it forward into this sixth round. See the air. I mean, she's trying to be positive, Mike, but at the same time, she's throwing air. I mean, Teresa's nowhere near the punches that she's throwing. So at the same time, she's trying to be positive. She's really not accomplishing very much.
Ward still on the toes, dancing. Trying to keep Perazzi at a distance. Still cat and mouse out there.
Yeah, I think in this round, Teresa is maybe starting to slow down a little bit, and she's maybe handing initiative back to April a little bit. But she's not really doing very much with it.
Not much action in this round. No, I believe they're both taking a breather here.
Yeah.
Or we could be in for a heck of a finish in this round. Because we haven't seen much here.
We're now in the final 10 seconds, and there we go. That's pretty much the round, I believe.
I'm giving that to April.
You give that to April?
I am.
Okay, then. Okay.
Mind you, it could have went either way, like you said, but I'm going to give it to April. I thought that Barazzi relaxed a little bit on that one.
Yeah, that's an element of that, Mike. I mean, she did relax. She wasn't as busy in that round. She let April come on to it a little bit more. But I have to say, I'm not sure that April landed any kind of meaningful punches. She came on to Therese a little bit more, but did she land any proper punches? I'm really not sure.
And you see the contrasting styles in the corner, whereas Ward sits and Barazzi stands. And she has Jamal Woolridge as her coach or advisor or instructor. Here we go, round number 7.
Let's see what her approach is to this round. Last round she took a round off, and it's now starting to be busier again.
Yep, she's coming back.
Oh, there you go, exactly that. Exactly, yeah. She's a lot busier.
That's what I thought. She took a breather in round 6.
Oh, I think April is really kind of hanging on now, Mike.
Yeah, I don't know how much more of this she can take.
Yeah.
I don't know how much more she's going to be able to take.
If Teresa keeps this up for the rest of this round, April could be in real trouble.
Yeah.
You can see it from that punch. I mean, she threw a punch, she tried to come forward, but it was one of those ones that were really quite flat. There was nothing behind it. It was more to keep Teresa off her rather than to be an aggressive counter punch herself.
Ward has to make contact. She's losing in those exchanges like that.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Mike. You're absolutely right. Yeah, when they're getting close and they're both throwing punches, clearly Teresa is a big winner when they get inside like that. And April really is, I mean, some counter punchers fight well off the back foot with the back of the ropes, but really Teresa isn't allowing April room to breathe in that kind of scenario. And
once again, Ward wisely ties her up, and that's round 7.
That's a no doubter, Mike, isn't it?
Yeah,
no doubter there.
That goes to Teresa. That's five rounds to 2 in Teresa's favor on the unofficial score sheet.
On our internal BSN scorecard, yeah. Yeah. And I think, to be honest, we've tried to be quite neutral with it. So it could quite honestly be 6-1 or 7-0 even for Teresa at this point. I think April really, really needs to pull something out of the bag.
We're generous, Greg. Come on. We're generous.
We try our best.
We're a generous people.
I would not like it to be said if I was anything other.
WBA middleweight world title fight. Round number 8 coming up. With champion Teresa Barazzi holding a commanding points lead according to our unofficial stats.
I wonder if Teresa's corner is telling her something other than just keep going forward, keep putting the pressure on her. If they're trying to tell her that that the scorecard is say 6-3 or that kind of ilk, that Teresa then thinks I just have to win one more round and I've won the fight on points. I hope that's not the case, and I hope they're telling her just to keep fighting and keep taking it to April. Keep putting her back foot. And I think that kind of answers the question, mate, don't you? I mean, that was quite the points from Teresa there.
See,
again, April's throwing a couple of punches,
connected.
But yeah, she's throwing an air.
She's not connected.
Yeah.
She's still dancing, though.
And again, I mean, kind of April there kind of fought her way off the ropes and she threw a few jabs and a few punches. But again, she's throwing air. She's not landing anything. So it means nothing effectively. Teresa, again, for me, is in complete control of this round. She's walking April down. She knows where April's going. She's cutting her off in the corner. She's being the aggressor this round. So that's another round for Teresa, for me.
Standing room only at the Barclay Gymnasium for Teachers Fight Night 14.
I think it's worth saying that they sold out Barclay Gymnasium, mate, don't you? This place is standing room only.
When I drove up and saw the amount of cars on the field, I said truly sold out. There's very little parking space on that massive field.
A couple of guys have said to me, we would have done well if we'd sold tickets to the parking lot as well.
Round number 9 of this WBA middleweight world title fight.
And I think we have it 6-2 for Teresa at the moment.
That's correct. Yeah. She's unofficially well ahead on points.
Yeah, I think April really needs to pull something out of the bag. She really can't keep fighting off the back foot because it's gotten her nowhere so far. She needs to be more aggressive. Start coming forward.
Teresa.
Or then again, Teresa might decide to fight right now. Yeah, April, you can see April. She's really sucking in the wind. She's struggling. She's really struggling.
Bleeding too from the mouth.
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to go the distance. Both of them are tired, but she's definitely bleeding from the mouth.
I think, to be fair as well, Teresa is fighting a dangerous game if she gets in this one, because really one punch could change the course of this fight. I think for me, if Teresa was fighting smart, she would pick her punches, certainly be more aggressive, but you know, not get engaged in so many brawls, because she is controlling this fight. She is dominating this fight, and she doesn't need to get involved in those kind of exchanges where one punch could change things.
Look at that exchange.
That's one of those that I think at the end of the day, Teresa probably came off best, but it gives April encouragement because it gives her a chance to come out and maybe land that punch that changes the fight and might just knock Teresa out. I think while I say that, I also want to say that I think Teresa is again controlling this round. And April is really struggling. Her back is always against the ropes. She has nowhere to go. And again, another round for Teresa.
Yeah, the way I see it, Greg, a unanimous points decision.
It's looking that way, Mike. It's looking that way.
Number 10, the last round of the night. And thank you, the lovely Danae.
I think for me, there's no way a judge could actually see it as a possible scenario.
I don't even know if she's coming out. She's having talks with the...
She's speaking to the referee.
Yeah. Might just be over.
No.
It's finished. It's all over. She's not coming back out.
No, or, I think she is, Mike. She is.
What is that sign there when the cross is like that?
I think the referee's just saying we're going to come out, we're going to touch gloves.
Right.
So respect.
Okay, so we have a 10th and final round then.
Taking the fighters forward. Touch gloves. Respect for each other.
The 10th and final round.
But as I was kind of half introducing there, Mike, excuse me, I don't believe there's any way a judge could legitimately score the fight any other way than Teresa in complete control of this.
Oh yeah, I believe she will win the fight, but I know that the fans were also hoping for a knockout.
Oh, absolutely, yes, absolutely. Fans love the knockout.
But I think they'll be happy with the win.
I'm sure they will. At the same time, fans love a world champion.
Ooh. But April Ward can hold her chin up high. Going the distance. She hasn't put much leather to Barazzi's chin, but she has hung around.
Mike, I would actually say I'm not quite so sure about that. I think respect to her, obviously. I mean, I certainly wouldn't like to get in the ring with Teresa, but at the same time, in a professional fight, when you know you're losing,
you
have to change tactics,
yes,
right? You have to come forward,
something.
You have to change the game.
Right.
So it's not enough to survive the fight. If you're losing the fight, you have to try and change things and come out and try and win the fight. I think at the same time, I don't want to be harsh to April because really she's been completely outgunned in this fight. So sometimes you have to show respect as well and say, you know what, she's done her best, she's been outmatched, and you have to show respect for that.
That'll do it.
So there can't be any doubt about this fight at all.
Eight rounds to two.
And I think, to be honest, that's been optimistic towards April. I think a judge could easily score this fight 10 rounds to nil towards Teresa. Easily score this fight that way.
I think that was worth the wait. What do you think? I think that was worth the wait.
Mike, we'll wait for the decision first, but I think if there's anything other than a Teresa victory, it's been a dramatic travesty of justice. But I think overall, for Teachers Fight Night, it's been a fantastic occasion and a fantastic night.
This is good for Bermuda boxing. It's good for Teachers Rugby Fight Night. It's good for Bermuda to have a world champion.
I think you can put it further, it's great for Bermuda Sport even. Bermuda Sport to have a world champion in our midst. And it's great for Bermuda to be a host at an event. And obviously as a part of Teachers Rugby Football Club, I'm delighted that we could be associated with this kind of event. Teresa there bouncing and dancing. Clearly pleased with her performance, as well as she should be.
Rousing success. We also like to thank our sponsors for the night.
Girl, me want fi just squeeze ya, put me things all around ya. Girl, you give me the tightest hold me ever get in my life. Me guy them jam, me no care. Me take it anytime, anywhere. In a square, so me no fear. Long as a woman, I will be there. Me want a girl, me can't wine for me. Me want a girl, me can't take care of me. Let me feel it, let me reveal it. Oh, me have to really squeeze it. Y'all me want for you all, yo. Put me arms right around, yo. Y'all you give me the tightest hold me ever get in my life. Y'all me just want for squeeze, yo. Put me things all around, yo.
Y'all okay, you ladies and gentlemen, we have the judge's decision. Judge Lynn Carter scored about 100-90. Judge Vic Richmond scored about 99-92. Judge Steve Weisfeld scored about 100-90. And the winner, and still the WBA World's Middleweight title holder, Teresa Barazzi!
That's interesting. Two of the judges and it's 10 runs to nil.
10 runs to nil, and the third judge called it 8-1 and the 10th run a draw. So, yeah. As I say, it's not a surprise. We tried to talk to Michigan, we gave him two rounds, but really, as much as we could give him.
Only thinking about themselves alone. Mr. Mickey, no baby, telling me how it's down. I know where them little boy, they will lose up from me.
Yeah, taking congratulations to Teresa. It's a quite fantastic performance.
Yet the after party for this night is at Docksiders. Both the back and front bar will be open, so if you still want to party and join the boxers and the champ, make your way down to Docksiders, one of our sponsors in tonight's event. We would like to thank We'd like to thank all of our sponsors that make Teachers Rugby Fight Night a success. Starting off for tonight's event with the Ministry of Youth, Families and Sports, the Ministry of Tourism, Gorham's, Linda's Group of Companies, Fairmont Hamilton Princess, Gatorade, Bacardi, Coors and Smirnoff, and Docksiders and Tops. Thank you very much. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves responsibly. Please take care in making your way home.